Hello students, in this session we discuss the data mining techniques. It is one of the important topic in our data mining. So it's data mining techniques in the sense it's like theoretical concepts of our statistical theory only. So all these terms are very familiar for you, how to apply our theoretical concepts in data mining. Actually, in the data mining, you should separate the data based on the requirement, based on the similarities actually. For that sake, how to apply the different statistical techniques here, that only considered as data mining techniques. So mainly the researchers identify the fundamental data mining techniques are prediction and description. These words are very familiar for you. Prediction in the sense you should estimate the value for the variable. Description in the sense how to apply that value for future data. All that are related to description area. So prediction, first observe, prediction makes use of existing variables in the database to predict unknown or future values of interest. So unknown values you should predict based on the previous data for past values. Like description focuses on finding patterns, describing the data and the subsequent presentation for user interpretation. Description. So once you predict the value, how to use that value in future purpose. So that only patterns and subsequent presentations should identify based on the description. So these two are very important in data mining techniques. So the relative emphasis of both prediction and description differ with respect to the underlying application and techniques. There are several data mining techniques fulfilling these objectives. Some of these are association, classification, sequential patterns and clustering. All these words are familiar for you. Association. Association in the sense in the big data. So what type of variables are associated or similar? That type of items you should separate and grouping that is related to the association. Then classification develops profiles of different groups. So classify the data in different groups is one of the main thing in data mining. You should classify like based on the tables or based on the similarities. You should classify that involve in the classification area. Sequential patterns. Similarities are there in the data. So that similarities you should take one area. Like suppose EMP table, DEPT tables are there. So in that employee ID is common for both table in the sense that you should take in one place. I mean first column or second column similarity, that sequential patterns you should arrange. Then clustering, so it's like related only like our association and classification. So clustering segments a database into subgroups or clusters. Suppose 1000 data is there, from the 1000 data you should observe that 1000 data in the sense is somehow difficult to identify our objectives. That type of situations what we can do in the sense 100 consider one group, from the 100 easily can identify what's our requirement. Like that from each group or subgroup or cluster you should identify our requirements. Clustering in the sense grouping like subsets. Like another approach to the study of data mining techniques is to classify the techniques as user guided or verification driven data mining, discovery driven or automatic discovery of rules. So these are related to our previous four only, but some more latest techniques we can apply here. Most of the techniques of data mining have elements of both models here, like user guided or discovery driven. So observe, verification model or user guided. So in verification model, verify the data based on our requirement. In this process of data mining, the user makes a hypothesis and tests the hypothesis on the data to verify its validity. Hypothesis testing is one of the main thing in data mining. So before going the experiment, what's your requirement that you consider hypothesis area? Based on based on our requirement, you should go through the verification, all that. The emphasis is on the user who is responsible for formulating the hypothesis and issuing the query and the data to affirm or negate the hypothesis. One example is there, yeah. So in supermarket, so suppose the people introduce one new item, in the sense, first they'll take one hypothesis, yeah, group of the people, this group of the people are interested, willing to buy that item. So how to check it, in the sense, so based on our requirement, you should go and survey that related item from the different customers. Based on that introduction of that item is suitable for releasing the marketer. There, like that, you should identify based on the hypothesis. This is only the verification model. So verify that item is suitable or not for market, like that, verify. So for verification sake, so you can use the hypothesis testing. Like discovery model. Actually, this verification model and discovery model are related only. So you should discover that concept from the market. Suppose, so here is also supermarket is one of the best example. So the discovery model differs in its emphasis in that it is the system that automatically discovers important information hidden in the data. So use data is there, from that our important data you should inquire, in the sense, discover, in the sense, that type of situations these models we can use. The data is shifted in such a frequently occurring patterns, trends and generalizations about the data without intervention or guidance from the user. The manner in which the rules are discovered depending on the class of the data mining application. Here is also consider one small example. An example of such a model is a supermarket database which is minded to discover the particular group of customers to be targeted by mailing campaign. The data is searched with no hypothesis, no need to take this area is enough or this area people are willing, like that. You should go through that without hypothesis. You should discover from our requirement from the customer say. So that's why here no hypothesis involved in the discovery model. In verification model, hypothesis is there. That is the main difference between verification model and discovery model. So what are the common characteristics found here? The typical discovery driven tasks are, these are the different tasks. So before entering into the models, all this we discussed lightly, but here you should go through that depth. Discovery of association rules, discovery of classification rules, clustering, discovery of frequently episodes, deviation detection. These tasks are an exploratory nature and cannot be directly handed over to the current available database techniques. So based on these rules, so you should discover the pattern, then go through that next step. So discovery step is one of the starting step in the data mining. So discovery of association rules. An association rule is an expression of the form X implies Y. So suppose two sets of items consider, in the two sets of items both are similar or both are related. So any differences are there, or we should identify. Suppose in one company of tea powder introduced in the market, suppose. So in that we consider all that relevant ingredients in that one set. So like that, it should take the another company one tea powder. So in that ingredients, all that should take. So both the sets associated are different. Like that, you should identify most of the ingredients are related to same. So same in the sense that two products are similar. So you should go through that, introduce that item in the market or not. That depends on the decision of the manager. It is another area. So like here is also two are there in this association. One is support and another is confidence. These two words are very familiar in our statistics. Support, how much data is support for both x and y. So it's related to the support area. Then confidence measures how much a particular item is dependent on other. So confidently you should provide, suppose you consider three roses, tea powder and Taj Mahal. So both are almost all related, both introduced by same company. So but what's the difference between their similarities, depending on another or not, it's related to the confidence area. This is about the discovery of association rule. Discovery of classification rule. So classify the data. Classification involves finding rules that partition the data into disjoint groups. So classify the data. So classification is one of the main word in our statistics. From first sem onwards used this classification. So class, suppose the data is total mixed, suppose in our class we consider 100 students data. So there is no clarity, nothing, total 100 students disorder data is there. What we can do, consider here in the sense, classify the data first. How to classify the data in the sense, consider roll number, name, subjects, like that we consider roll number 1, 2, 3 like that, and with respect to names, their subject marks, all that classify. This is only the classification. So in the classification, the classification involves finding rules that partition the data into disjoint groups. So based on the given data, you should classify the data into different groups. The input for the classification is the training data set, whose class labels are already known. So based on their requirement, they'll give the label names like column headings. So basing on that, you should classify. Classification analysis the training data set and construct a model based on the class label and aims to assign a class label to the future unlabeled records. Once you consider the labeled records one side, easily identify unlabeled records in another side. Basing on that, what type of data is required for classification, all that you consider. Since the class field is known, this data of classification is known as supervised learning. So once the label is known, so no need to go through that another way, is like supervised only. So other than that, it's considered as unsupervised learning. There are several classification discovery models, decision trees, neural networks, generic algorithm, statistical models like linear geometric discriminants, all that are related to discovery of classification rules. It is very familiar for you. Then clustering. So clustering, you know this word clearly. So clustering in the sense, the total data divided into different subgroups. Set of items you should separate into the subsets. Clustering is a method of grouping data so that the data in each group shares similar trends and patterns. Based on the similarity, trends and patterns, you should separate the data. So clustering constitutes a major class of data mining algorithm. So algorithm attempts to automatically partition the data space into a set of regions or clusters to which the examples in the table are assigned, either deterministically or probability wise. So there is no specific rule for clustering the data. So based on the probability, so similarities, you should consider the data into different subgroups like. Then clustering according to similarity is a concept which appears in many disciplines. If a measure of similarity is available, then there is a number of techniques for formulating this cluster. So another approach is to build set functions that measures some particular property of groups. The objectives of this clustering is to uncover natural grouping. So if any group is not cover that type of situations, consider these objectives. To initiate hypothesis about the data, so based on the consideration, this cluster is satisfied or not, should check. To find consistency and valid organization of the data is also another objective of the clustering. So the next objective is here. So discovery of frequent episodes. So it's frequently repeated items, consider one area. So for that sake, different types of episodes are there here. So first, frequently episodes are the sequence of events that occur frequently, so close to each other, and the extracted from the time sequence. So how close it has to be considered? It has frequency is domain dependent. So this is given by the user as the output, the input, and the output are the prediction rules for the time sequence. Based on that given input data, the output depends. So what are the different types of episodes involved here? In the sense, serial episodes, parallel episodes, non-serial and non-parallel episodes. Serial episodes, so one by one they will consider, one after another they will consider the episodes. In the sense, it's considered as sequential episodes, serial episodes, the serial episodes which occur in the sequence order wise. The parallel episodes, in the sense, it's parallelly, so in one item set, first item, second item, like that they will consider. In the second data set also, first item is similar to first item of the previous set, second item is similar to second item of the, parallelly the work is going on, that considered as the parallel episodes. The parallel episodes in which there is no constraints order, no constraints on the order of the events given, is considered as the parallel. So if the data is in disorder, there is no serial or no parallel, the type of situations, the non-serial and non-parallel episodes which occur in the a sequence of occurrence of the events precede an occurrence of another event, then there is no constraint on the relative order of the events given. So these applications includes telecommunication area, you can use this, share market analysis sake also you can use the, so this frequently episodes. So like these are mainly used for temporal data only. So temporary data, so based on today's data you should discover that tomorrow's situation. Like then deviation detection, so deviation, this very familiar for you. So deviation, what's the difference between the different data sets detect here? So deviation detection is the identification of outlying points in a particular data sets. What are the differences between the different data sets? We consider deviation detection area and explain whether they are due to noise or other impurities being present in the data, or due to trivial reasons. So why the data sets are deviate one another, in the sense, so many reasons are there. From the reasons you should identify what's the reason it is. It is usually applied with database management segmentation. So at the time of segmenting the data, we can use the deviation detection, and is the source of true discovery, since the outlier express deviation from some previously known expectations and norms. Based on previous expectations, there you should detect the deviations. By calculating the value of measure of current data and comparing them with previous data as well as with the normative data, the deviations can be obtained. They can be applied in forecasting, so predict the variable future. So that forecasting area you can use. Fraud detection, customer retention also you can use this deviation detections. Okay, so this is one of the very important question in our first unit of data mining. Should more focus and explain about data mining techniques.